A story is told in the book of Luke chapter 17 verse 11 to 19 about the 10 lepers. While Jesus was heading to Jerusalem, these men stood at a distance and called on Jesus, "Master, have mercy on us." Jesus told them, "Go and show yourselves to the priests." And they did, and they were healed. None of them walked away, but only one man came back to Jesus and said, "Thank you, Jesus, for your mercy and grace." Today, oh God, I come like this one man just to say thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Tune the sound music.
Join me.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome again to this episode of State of Society, hashtag My Story. We do apologize because the last 2 weeks we didn't give you a show and we had a break and we were working on some few things here and there to make sure that we improve on our set, on everything that we give you. And today I have an artist who has an X factor in history, I promise you. This guy is Nana Music Kenya. Julius Nana, you may have seen some of his videos on your screens. And if you looked at Twitter, or if you use Twitter on a regular basis, you may have noticed in the month of October, since the month of August to October, there was a video that was trending, a million blessings, hashtag a million blessings. And this guy did this song. He's a worship leader, he's a spiritual man, and we want to get to know his story because there's an X factor in this story, I promise you.
Boss, welcome to my show.
Sun.
By the way, we are shooting this one in HEWANE Records.
Thanks.
That is in Juja.
It's my pleasure, I'm humbled.
Who exactly is what you call yourself, Nana Music KE?
Nana Music KE, Nana Music Kenya. I'm a worship leader, a musician, an artist, and a man of God. So, ukiniona unajua mimi ni mtumishi wa Bwana.
Yeah. So you say that when you call yourself a worship leader means you are a pure Christian in nature, you music is pure Christian music, or do you do other kind of art?
Now when you talk about being a worship leader,
yeah,
I mean that I lead people in worship.
Okay.
And worship is the highest glory to God, highest honor to God. And I lead people to that place, in the Holy of Holies, to worship to God. So basically, this is not something I chose myself to do, or something that I thought, I think I can do it, it's a talent. No.
Yeah.
This is a personal relationship with God grown to a place whereby you feel you can lead other people to where I have been. So in other words, you cannot be a worship leader if you yourself, you're not a worshiper.
Yeah.
So first I was a worshiper for me to lead other people in worship.
So you can, you cannot teach other people what you do not practice anyway.
Exactly.
Alright, so tell us, how did this journey of your music up to, you know, being able to set this kind of a studio and being able to have a song that's trending for weeks on Twitter, how has this journey been up to this point and where did this start?
Okay, bottom line, everything here is talent and passion.
Yeah.
I realized my talent when I was still young. And when I say young, it's so many years ago, when I was still growing in class 1, class 2, 3 and 4 there. And the things I used to do just in pursuit of my talent really made my parents see that clearly I had a good talent and a passion in music.
Yeah.
And they supported me from that tender age. And the journey began there.
Mm-hmm.
And because I loved music, it is part of my talent, I followed it. Throughout high school in our church, a local church, and I was an instrumentalist, and music was all around me. Yeah,
when so I was growing up. So you've sung all these years?
Yeah, so all these years I've been a musician, and I've grown every year, every day, and every part of my life as a musician. And leaving that alone doesn't mean that I've been doing music all my life.
Yeah.
I've been doing music together with other things in life, my education and all that. But because it's my talent and my passion, I followed it, and this is where it has brought me.
Yeah. So I understand you're also a banker. You're working full-time for Diamond Trust Bank.
Don't say, man.
No, but you do.
Yeah.
Before you tell us how you get to balance between, you know, being an active musician, which I imagine writing songs and being able to create time for studio is quite demanding, and balancing that with your other full-time job as a banker, we'll take a break and have a look at one of his videos called Bakubize.
sifanywani mwako
Alright, welcome back to State of Society, hashtag my story, and I have Nana Music, K-E, and that's what he called himself. And we're talking about he's telling us about his journey into music, and you said that you've been singing since you were young, which means through your schooling, you are also participating in some music activities.
Yeah, sure.
And now you've come to recording music actively. Now, tell us about Diamond Trust Bank.
Okay, I may not be able to touch about the bank.
Okay.
But what I'll tell you is you need to do something called balancing your work and your passion and your talent all together. And that's one thing I believe God has given me the grace to do, to balance. Yeah. Even I know my workmates usually ask me, how do you do this? How do you do music? We are here from 8 to 5,
yeah,
and
the
then
you
get home 7, and then you're still doing your music, you're seeing you on the screens and all that. How do you do it?
But when do you go to studio?
Now, I have a studio here.
Yeah.
So,
yeah, I know this is your premise,
let me give you a breakdown of my day.
Yeah.
And you'll understand now where music comes in and where banking really comes in.
Yeah.
And I usually wake up early, 3 a.m. I do my devotion together with my family.
Yeah.
Yeah.
3 a.m.?
Yes, 3 a.m.
Wow.
I do devotion together with my family up to about 4.
Okay.
And then from 4, I can sing, I can worship, listen to some music.
Yeah.
And then if there's something I need to practice about my vocals, I do it that time in the morning hours. And then also, that is now after all that, now I prepare to go to work.
Yeah.
So now after work, that is from 7, because I get to the studio at 7.
Mm-hmm.
I try to do my tracks, whatever I've been singing, or the songs that God has given me, I try to record them, to make them, and also to listen to what people are doing, in the music industry, because music is so dynamic.
Yeah,
you have to keep listening to what people are doing, in the industry. Mm-hmm. So that's the time I spend that time to listen, to grow my career and to sharpen my talent and all that. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Do you write your own songs, or someone writes them for you?
I write my own songs. So far, I've written my own songs.
Okay.
But lately, I've got some support from an upcoming artist, because one thing that I'm passionate about is also to support young talent,
the upcoming ones,
and nurturing them into being people who can really lead people in this industry. Because if you've realized, this industry is very needy. It requires people who are strong and sounded. Mm-hmm. If you're really a Christian, you have to be sounded for you to be a minister and to stand there and lead people in music, in worship, and whatever they are calling music industry in the gospel scene.
Okay.
So there's this young man, he's my little brother.
Okay.
Yeah. We have a little gap in terms of our ages, and he's an upcoming talented guy.
Yeah.
And I've took him into my music, and he's written some bit of my music.
He
contributed a bit of the verse one.
Oh. Yeah. But on the main recording, you see there that the voice?
No, the vocals is not there.
Okay.
He only assisted me with some bits of my A Million Blessings, where I got started. I could ask him.
Okay.
Actually, he's very knowledgeable when it comes to writing music.
Right.
And I've actually done a song with him.
All right.
Yeah, you can have him one time in these shows.
Right.
And there's a collab we've done with him.
Okay.
It's called Sifai.
Right.
And if you listen to that song, you'll understand, because
it's on YouTube.
It's on
so
YouTube.
You are,
he's written
you are
the whole
can.
Song.
All right.
He's written the whole song. So
that's great.
We'll be able to understand the magnitude of his talent.
Okay.
We'll be singing the song.
Now, you seem to be quite versatile, because you also featured in a movie in 2014. This one you told me offline. I didn't want to skip this part, but you also acted in a movie which was a musical.
Yeah.
And you did a quite crucial part, which was some very emotional soliloquy part of it.
Taking me way back, man.
I know it's way back, but tell us, how was the experience of now you fitting into a character where you had to sing and at the same time act in a movie?
First, I appreciate that chance to act in a musical movie.
Yeah.
I've never known I can act, but when the producer of the movie approached me and asked me, "You guy, I've seen you do music and you're doing it well, why can't you feature in this movie and you have good vocals?" And I said, "Why not?" Like, because he's a friend of mine, I gave him all the support and went into the movie, and he gave me actually a major part, a very major part, and it was a challenge to me, because I've not acted actively before, but this was my first chance to act in a very serious movie. And being a musical, it wasn't very hard for me to.
So would you say that the movie contributed to your growth in terms of, you know, building your confidence as an artist, as a person?
Confidence is really a process. It's not a one-time thing. But what I can say, the movie really gave me, it came like an eye-opener.
Yeah.
I could see many opportunities, things that I've never thought I can do. Mm-hmm. I could see myself doing them there.
Yeah.
And I was like, wow, kumbe I can act, kumbe I can.
Maybe you can.
So I was able to explain so many things I didn't know about myself.
Okay.
And even to understand myself even better.
And working with a huge group of people.
And again, working with many people.
Yeah.
And the dynamics that come with it. Mm-hmm. Understand, when you see people doing movies, you understand truly they've sacrificed and they took in a lot.
Alright, So we're going to take another short break, a very short break. And here is another amazing video and a song that he did in 2013.
Lakini mimi sizamu, nimekatana, nimekatana. Mawimbi ni mengi, na meli ya zama. Oh baba, tuliza mawimbi, vitani vikale, siwezi jimudu. Oh Yesu, unipiganie, moyo wangu razima, motisha wangu kawibu kuzama. Oh Yesu, wako ute ushindi. Mawimbi, mawimbi
Baba,
mawimbi na vita vikali.
Baba,
mawimbi ya adui, ya adui.
Baba,
mawimbi ya kuni yangamiza.
Baba,
mawimbi, mawimbi ni mekataya ni yangamiza mimi. Nikisoma neno vizuri, Mungu ananiambia ni yeye nguvu zangu.
Welcome back, and we are still with Nana Music KE, Nana Music. And remember, we are doing this interview set on inside his studio, actually, HEWANE Music Records, based in Juja, Central Kenya. And we've gotten your story now, and I just wanted to know, what challenges do you face as a person, you know, collectively, in and out of music?
Some challenges in and out of music. Let me begin with music, the music career and whatever comes with music.
Yeah.
One of the challenges is keeping the pace and making it better every day.
Yeah.
It's not easy for you to do music and to do music for God, not just any music, do music for God.
I know there is a difference and between singing for God and singing about God.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And anybody can sing about God, but singing for God is not something easy all the time. And you know you have to do it every time.
So keeping the pace.
Keeping the pace, which is not easy. It comes really in handy.
So what do you have to do to make sure that you remain relevant and you keep this pace?
Your personal devotional life has to stay on the high.
Okay.
And then number two, you have to engage yourself with people who are really supporting you in this ministry, because it's really ministry. Not people who are giving you wrong advice. There are people who will tell you, boss, tuwa ngoma, ngoma inakaa hivi, manza lafu ikuwe hype, tunajua nini, nini, nini. And actually, that is a percentage that really takes the market.
Yeah.
People who are telling you, do this kind of music, they want to lead you, they have to do this thing. And then you know you have to maintain your integrity as a Christian and as a worship leader.
Yeah.
So that's really a major challenge. And these are the people you're supposed to reach out to.
Yeah.
So it's like they are, from the word go, they have created an attitude that if this guy doesn't do hyped music, I don't think I'll listen to him again.
Yeah.
So now keeping up with that is a challenge.
Now this is another part that ladies want to know most of the time. Mm-hmm. Are you married?
Yeah, I have a family.
Oh, you have a family?
I have a family.
Well, how many children now?
Many children, but biologically one.
Biologically one. What do you mean by biologically one?
I've nurtured so many people,
okay.
and most of them call me dad.
Are you sure not all of them are your own biological children?
Others are even older than me, but
okay.
Yeah, they're spiritual children. So I have many, but biologically I have one lovely daughter.
Okay.
She's called Lyra.
All right.
She also loves music. slave dad, married to a beautiful wife, Dorcas Chalangat Lele.
All right. Now, what's your last take, or what's the last words you can say, especially to someone who is trying to pursue music and relevant music?
If you're pursuing music, it depends which kind of music you're pursuing. And if you're pursuing secular music, I don't want to discourage you. Just continue doing what you're doing. But remember that the gift you have is from God. And in the way you're using it, just ask yourself if God was there, you would really appreciate it. Mm. And then the other thing I would tell to my fellow gospel musicians is that let's not commercialize music, and then we forget that we've been called to preach and to reach out to people who are very needy, people who have poor spirits, their souls are so demanding, the grace of God. Let's not forget that. So let's remember the Great Commission and reach out with the heart of preaching the gospel to people who are really needy. And let's remember that when we do something that we are following our passions and forgetting God and putting God down, let's remember that wages of sin is death. And probably you are living on a late death.
Yeah.
So please make sure that you're cautioned and do music that glorifies the Father.
All right. Okay. And what's your next project now apart from...
I'm working on another single to add on to my album.
Anything for Christmas and, this festive season?
Yeah. All right. That's coming. Okay. But that's like a takeoff.
Okay.
Yeah. But majorly, I'm working on a single to add on to my album. Mm-hmm. And actually, this is written by my young brother.
Okay.
So, okay.
Yeah.
And basically...
We'll have him here for sure.
Let me tell you, this guy is he's talented.
Yeah.
And I'm doing this to just give him a chance and even to encourage him, him in his ministry. Because these young people are lacking people to nurture them.
Yeah, and to get mentorship
and to see what they're supposed to do with their talents and what they're not supposed to do. Mm-hmm. Because let me tell you, if they are following anybody in the gospel industry, they may follow the wrong person.
Yeah, definitely.
But we need us, at least people who understand the gospel. Mm-hmm. We're supposed to be there for them, to nurture them, to lead them and show them the way.
Right.
So basically, I'm doing this song just to encourage this young talent and to let people know that, yes, God is doing something through some young people, and also to show the young people that young people can really do something in the gospel industry.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you very much, and thank you very much for, you know, allowing us to come and use your studios. And in case, because I want you to do the final song for us at live music, maybe you can tell our viewers where your studio is located again and the contact, so that whoever wants to come and record voiceovers and music in this studio can get you easily.
HEWANE Records is located at Juja Professional Center. This is Juja Stage, and this is on 4th floor, and we are available. Check us out on Instagram, HEWANE Records. You can also check us on FB, HWN Records. Yeah.
All right. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. I really appreciate that you are able to watch this episode, and we promise you that we'll continue to give you amazing stories that will touch your life, and that's my intention. All right, he's going to give us the last song as we wind up.
You ready?
Yeah.
So this is a Christmas tune.
All right.
Going to all the guys who are ready traveling.
Okay.
Najua watu wa Mungoma wameanza ku travel Mombasa. Yeah. So
na mizigo, na meza.
Na mizigo, na meza.
Na kuku.
Na bucket za kuoga kwa ocean, please.
Yeah.
Ocean ni ukusimu. See, but you.
Alright. So, let's do this, let's do this.
Let's do this. snappy.